Hello friends, this video on whole numbers part 5 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now, based on whatever we have studied so far, let us quickly look at some of the questions. Question number 1. Write the successor of 2440701. Now, what was that simple tip that we learned? That whenever we have to find successor, we just need to add 1 to that number. So in the first case, this is the number 2440701. So we will add 1 to this number. So what do we get? We get 2440702. So this is the successor. Let us look at the next number, which is 1099999. So let's add 1 to it. So when you add 1, so this is what you get. So this would be the successor. So 11 lakh would be the successor of this number. Question number 2. What is the predecessor of 10,000? So in order to find predecessor, all that we need to do is we need to subtract 1. So 9999 would be the predecessor. Let's look at the second number, which is 208090. So here also you'll subtract 1. So the number that was given was 2,08,090. So when you subtract 1, you get 2,08,089. So this would be the predecessor. Question number 3. Which of the following statements are true and which are false? 0 is the smallest natural number. So this is absolutely false, because 0 is not at all a natural number. The smallest natural number is 1 and 0 is a whole number. 400 is the predecessor of 399. That is also false, because 400 is the successor of 399. Because 400 comes after 399. In fact, we can say that 399 is the predecessor of 400, because 399 comes before 400. 0 is the smallest whole number. Yes, that is absolutely true. 600 is the successor of 599. That is also true, because if you add 1 to 599, you get 600. All natural numbers are whole numbers. That is also true, because what are whole numbers? Whole numbers are all natural numbers plus 0. So that would mean that you pick up any natural number, that natural number is going to be a whole number. So all natural numbers are whole numbers, but all whole numbers are not natural number, because 0 is a whole number, but 0 is not a natural number. All whole numbers are natural numbers. False. Why false? Because 0, which is a whole number but not a natural number. The predecessor of a two-digit number is never a single-digit number. This is also absolutely false. Let us look at the example of 10. What would be the predecessor of 10? You subtract 1 from 10 and you would get it as 9. So the predecessor of a two-digit number can be a single-digit number. So this is false. 1 is the smallest whole number. False, because 1 is not a whole number, it is a natural number. The natural number 1 has no predecessor. Of course it has, because if you subtract 1 from 1, what do you get? You get 0. So 0 is the predecessor of 1. The whole number 1 has no predecessor. What do you say about this? Is 1 a whole number at all? 1 is not a whole number. 1 has a predecessor, that is 0. But 1 is not a whole number. Therefore, it is false. The whole number 13 lies between 11 and 12. That is again false, because when you add 1 to 11, you get 12. When you add 1 to 12, you get 13. So basically on the number line, 12 lies between 11 and 13. So this is false. The whole number 0 has no predecessor. So what would you say about this? 0, is there any predecessor of 0? Now, the whole number 0 doesn't have a whole number predecessor. That's because before 0, what do you have? Before 0, we have the negative numbers. So before 0, all that is present is minus 1. So you really do not have a whole number predecessor of 0. The successor of a two-digit number is always a two-digit number. That is also not really true, because if you take example of 99, what is the successor of 99? If you add 1 to 99, what do you get? You get 100. So the successor of a two-digit number can be a three-digit number. Question number 4. In each of the following pairs of numbers, state which whole number is on the left of the other number on the number line. Also write them with the appropriate sign greater than or less than between them. So let us look at the first pair of numbers, 370 and 307. So which one is greater? So of course 370 is greater than 307, right? Now, where will they lie on the number line? So we know that the greater numbers lie towards the right. So which is a greater number? 370. So let's say if 370 lies somewhere here, so 307 being a smaller number would lie towards its left. So 307 would lie somewhere here. So if we assume that we have 0 somewhere here, so 307 would lie to the left of 370. Let's look at the next one, which is 98,765 and 56,789. So which will be greater, 56,000 or 98,000? Of course, 98,000 would be greater than 56,000. So when you place them on the number line, 98,000 would be on the right hand side of 56,000. So 56,000 would be on the left hand side of 98,000 on the number line, because always remember that as you go towards right, you go towards greater numbers. As you go towards left, you go towards the smaller numbers. So a smaller number will always lie on the left of the greater number. Question number 5. Write the three whole numbers occurring just before 10001, which is nothing but 10,001. So this is the number that is given. So we have to find out the number which occurs just before this. So let us subtract 1. So when you subtract 1, you get 10,000. So 10,000 will lie just before 10,001. So let's say this is 10,001. So 10,000 will lie just before 10,000. 10,000 will lie just before 10,001. Now what will lie before 10,000? So for that you'll have to again subtract 1. So this is 9, this is 9, this is 9, this is 9. So just before 10,000 would be 9,999. What would be just before 9,999? Again subtract 1. So this would be 9,998. So you would have 9,998. So when you look at the number line, so these would be the three numbers which lie just before 10,001. That is 9,998, 9,999 and 10,000. So these are the three immediate numbers before.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.